Hello and welcome to this second segment of personal hygiene, where we are discussing post-sexual hygiene. Now, what do you do after? Many women struggle with, what do I do with the semen or the sperms, assuming you're having non-protected sex. So the easiest thing to do is to have the pelvic floor exercises, that is the Kegel exercises. Those who don't know about the Kegel exercises, you should know about them. They are the exercises that strengthen your vaginal muscles. What do? You just suck in your vagina and release. If you feel like that is hard enough, try from the anal region, sucking your bowel and release. It is something that most people were taught to do when they were passing urine, and you're told that when you're passing urine, you should go in beats when you stop. It's a good thing, but Kegel exercises should not be performed when passing urine. You should actually do them any other time, because they could tap some bacteria back into the urinary tract system. So that is what is going to help you remove the sperms, because you just squeeze them out in a maybe squatting position, and you can just squeeze them out and you will be good. After that, you use a clean towel. In our previous video, we talked about using a special vagina towel. That is what you will use, wet, not dry. Do not use anything dry, because something dry could hurt your very active and sensitive skin. So do not use anything dry, no tissues, no t-shirts, no socks, no all those things. Let us go. Just that wet vagina towel. Always have one with you. If you are at a place where you can't access that, I would advise you invest in some cotton wool. Also, that comes in handy. So that is something that you can consider. The other thing is, do not douche. Do not put anything into the vagina after you have had sex. Do not put water, do not put any kind of cleaning material, do not put your fingers, nothing. Just clean the vulva, Kegel out the sperms if you have to, and then the vagina will clean itself up. So do not douche. The other thing is, there are people who believe that you should massage the area with hot water to clean it up. No, don't do that, because it might mess up your vagina. So do not do that. Just if you feel like you have strained the muscle or you have strained the vagina, the easiest and the best thing to do is to probably use some cold water. If you can handle ice, it will probably work best for you. So yes, you can do that. The other thing is, do not use any kind of soap. Do not use any kind of soap, because people have been lied to that when you clean with soap, you're going to eliminate the odor that comes from the sexual odor. Do not use soap. Like I've said, plain water is enough. So, should we actually take a bath after having sex? Yes, I advise that you take a bath if you're in a position to take a bath, assuming that you can actually access a bathroom. It is important. Why? Because you need to clean up the sweat, and you need to clean up the exchange of dead skin, which brings about a foul smell. So it is advisable to take a bath if you can access a bath. And if you are having that activity on your bed, it is important that you actually change your sheets quite regularly, because you are sweating more and you are shedding more dead skin. The other thing is, it is advisable that you actually go to pee after sex, because in case there is any kind of introduction of bacteria, you can actually take it away from near the urethra, so that it doesn't actually get into the urethra. So it is advisable that you actually get to pee. The other thing is, do not use white. This kind of laziness that you actually don't want to use your catowel, it's not nice. So do not use wipes unless you are using intimate wipes, sexual wipes. So if you don't have access to those, just keep it the catowel. And it said no socks, no t-shirts and hoods and whatever. Yeah, just keep it that. Pay attention to yourself. I keep saying that we need to fall in love with ourselves enough for us to actually take good care of ourselves without feeling as if it's taking too much of our time, too much of our energies. The other thing is the kind of clothing, innerwear, that you wear after having sexual intercourse. Because, I mean, even if you do all the cleanup and then you go and put the wrong kind of innerwear, it's going to bring about problems. So keep it cotton, keep it loose fitting, not very tight. No thongs, no G-strings, because there has been activity there. The skin has been altered in a way. There's a lot of probably heat. There's the environment is very good for bacteria to multiply. And then if you go putting on a thong and then there's friction, there's skin breakages, irritation and all that, you can see where I'm going with this. So yeah, just keep it cotton and keep it loose fitting. I always ask, I mean, when you're walking on the road and going about your work, who is actually looking at the kind of panty that you're wearing? I don't get it. I just don't. So just so you know, the person who actually came up with the thong and the G-string was looking at exposing their body when they were sunbathing as much as they could. But it's not for walking in. So you can do that for entertainment purposes, but not for walking in if you actually do love your vagina. Yeah, so I look forward to having you on the next segment where we shall be discussing something equally juicy, equally nice. And if you have questions, you can bring them about. See you then.